Hello and welcome back to FT Business School. Though it has a population of just 10 million people, Sweden punches well above its weight in creating internationally recognised companies. IKEA, Volvo, ABB, Tetra Pak, Electrolux and even Skype and Spotify, the music streaming service. So what is it about the Swedish business culture that creates such successful businesses? And what does this mean for business schools there? Lars Strannegård has recently been appointed president of the Stockholm School of Economics. Professor Strannegård, we hear a lot about different business cultures, the European business culture, Chinese business culture is different from the US one. Is there a special Scandinavian business culture or even a special Swedish one?
Yeah, I do think there is something you could call a Scandinavian model or a Swedish model. And it's something about the smallness of the country in the first place. It's, as you said, it's some 10 million people. And already from the early days of industrialization, Swedish companies have always started out nationally, and then within a few months or a few years, they have gone global. So the concept of going global and being truly global is a Swedish heritage from a long time back.
It's been a small country that has developed this country.
Yeah, exactly. The home market is way too small, so you start thinking big in a way quite early.
But is there something about the culture within the companies as well?
Yeah, I think so too. It's an egalitarian culture where it's actually possible to the hierarchies and the chains of command are not non-existent, but they are quite, the organizations are flat. No titles are used, etc. So it's actually possible to go to anybody. It's easy to find funding, etc. So it's quite accessible. It's an accessible culture, and I think that's due to smallness too.
Right. So what does this mean for business schools like the Stockholm School of Economics?
We are really we're collaborating a whole lot with different companies, of course. And we are becoming very close to them too, so we build relationship. We've been around for 100 years, so we build a relationship with companies. And we come really close to them. They let us in into their deciding rooms and into their businesses. So we open up to our students. So the students are actually interacting a whole lot with companies during their education. So that's something that really creates a good mixture of theory and practice.
So from a student point of view, it is that corporate perspective, that closeness to the corporate world, that's very different from more academic institutions.
Yeah, I think it's the entire model is close collaboration. It's Swedish business culture and societal, the societal model is really about collaboration. So we do that in basically everything we do. So I think that really explains a whole lot. Collaboration and smallness, and that you really are interacting with each other.
But from a student perspective, I mean, is there an issue about the smallness of the country? I mean, students usually like to go to a big centre like New York or London or Paris. I mean,
I think it's a great opportunity for people coming from abroad. We see it more and more students are interested in Sweden because of Swedishness, lots of things. Stockholm is an extremely innovative place. And the model in itself, where it's many of our international students speak about, a fair amount of work-life balance, for instance. And the entire model is something that they are extremely attracted by. So I think the smallness in itself, it makes it more personal. Our school is quite small too, so you have a proximity between teachers or faculty and students, and lots of companies coming in. So I think the smallness is a huge advantage to us.
And does that closeness to corporations, does that help you in funding?
Of course, it helps us a lot in funding because they really understand what we are doing and they want to collaborate, they want to come closer to us. So it's absolutely key to our funding as well.
Professor Strannegård, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
To keep up to date with business school news and analysis, go to ft.com/businesseducation.